So for this is attenuation. So you can see here resistors have connected R1, R3, R2, RK and R6 and R4, right? So this I have to again connect it to my this. So the main purpose of this attenuation is it should get the constant output what we are going to do. So now you can see here I have connected, I have made R6, R4 and R1, R3, R2 and R4 all are connected in this fashion on the breadboard. Now I have to connect this to my plus and minus of my this. So you can just see this is also connected, this node is also connected where R4 and R3 are there. So you can just see how I have made the connections properly. I'm showing you this all should come in one line, this node all three should come in one line, so that all three have come in one line, which I am showing you here. These three also are connected in one line. Okay, what else now? That plus and negative has to be connected. So for that what you can do is I'm just connecting my positive to this resistor. Okay, so now here I'm connecting this positive and negative, I have to connect it to my R2 and R4 where they are meeting up. Okay, so at that point I have to connect my negative. So R2 and R4 are connecting point where, so there I have to connect my this. Okay, so now what I will do is I will just connect that. Fine, so now this is how the connection for your attenuation is being made. Okay students, so this is how the connections for your attenuation experiment has been made, and now you can see all the connections have been done properly. Okay, so thank you students. So now, okay, so I hope everything is clear in the connections. There is no doubt in any of the connections done over here. Okay students, thank you very much.